Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we have very unexpected news. Skill, what kind of unexpected news? Large boxes is returning to World of Tanks. Who could ever thought that? Who could ever thought that, fellas? So once again, not a big surprise, right? And the main question, is Valua going to be the same as it was in 2018, 19, 17, right? This is the question, and we can check it out very, very quickly by watching the video and what Wargaming is presenting to us. So let's see.
The holiday ops train is already speeding toward us, filled to the brim with festive spirit and wonderful surprises.
Who could imagine that, fellas? Large boxes.
Select large
boxes from four collections. It is quite funny how they waited for the last moment to publish them.
Guaranteed reward. Gold and two decorations of the course.
250 gold each box plus two decorations. But fellas, the most important thing right here is if you are buying the Christmas boxes yearly, as an example, in the first week, on the first day when they are released, right? Remember, your garage atmosphere level is going to hit maximum. And what that basically means, you will get immediately 50% credit boosters for bloody 1 month ahead of you. So that's the probably biggest award of all this, in my opinion.
Prizes. More gold, days of World of Tanks premium account, credits, 3D styles, or one of the premium vehicles.
And none of those things are bad so far.
C45.
Oh,
the first vehicle with
Trashante.
An auto reloading system. It can be played as a classic heavy tank.
Fellas, I'm not a big fan of this vehicle, but I believe there is going to be people which will enjoy it.
GSOR 1008.
I haven't tested Gusor yet, but I will very, very, very soon. You can expect this vehicle soon in the YouTube channel, maybe even tomorrow.
The Burask.
Borat, extremely good vehicle, but obviously for players which know what they are doing. If you are a new player in World of Tanks, ISU is going to be better for you.
Equipped with the legendary BL-10 gun, doesn't care what's in front of it, a tier 6 or a tier 10 vehicle.
Through that, I mean, you don't need to spam gold with this
also,
vehicle, so that's quite good.
Large boxes can contain lower tier vehicles. The Locust.
Now the main answer into your question, but skill, why the loot boxes is having the lower tier tanks? Well, that's the main point of all this, right? The main rewards are the big tiers, right? Those four tier eights. And this is you know how we can call this lowering the value of the box, right? I believe there is going to be a bigger chance you are going to get yourself Luchs than you are going to get yourself Trashante. But in the same time, I mean, it will add up over time, but in my opinion, those lower tier shitters, right, they are pretty much making the box value a bit lower. But it was happening every single year, although before I don't really think we had lower tiers as tier 3. I think lowest tank was a tier 5. So tier 3 value in gold, I don't know, like 500 gold maximum, right? So, yeah.
The T-15, the Matilda Black Prince, the T-78, and the French Sherman with an autoloader. If you get
so
a
as you can see,
a box, you
plenty of
garage, you will receive
plenty of lower tier shitters.
The surprises don't end there. You can also find 5 new 3D styles in large boxes.
5 new 3D styles. Let's see.
The 60TP Lewandowskiego, a modification of a tank that went through a complete factory rework.
Nice.
The Mouse. A real
a lot of mouse. I know we have a lot of mouse lovers, so you will love this, I think. But it's looking buzzy as a skin.
The Conqueror GC.
Really?
British,
I mean, no one is seeing
really
the Arta Camo. It's still neck. It's all the time next to the red line. No one cares.
Covered in pine branches, it is ready for both ambushing and aggressive assaults.
STB-1, one of the popular tanks nowadays,
the
right?
WZ-111-5A.
Ooh, my Whip tank, my towers. Tank, fellas.
It brings terror to the battlefield
nice.
Like an ancient dragon.
One of my favorite tanks right there, even though it's not the most epic.
3D styles from the previous year.
I see. So what they are doing, what they are doing right there, they are returning the old 3D styles into the boxes. So if you are particularly hunting for those five new styles, or particularly Vaza style, as an example, like I am Vaza lover, right? You will get Jack Pizda style, you will get other style, you will get other style, and it's going to be quite complicated thing. I would wait a second. Let's finish it, and I will say my opinions.
What's missing from your collection? Select large boxes right in your garage or in the premium shop.
And when your wife will figure out how many, how much money you spend on the loot boxes, you are going to be in trouble.
Wishes come true.
Okay, beautiful. Thank you very much. So, quick information, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, what do I think about this? Honestly, I think boxes is the best value out there. Hate me, love me, do whatever you want, but I think the loot boxes are the best value in the game. What is the biggest problem of all this? I believe Wargaming should not hide the content between the loot boxes. As an example, 3D skin. Someone don't want to buy the loot boxes, someone don't want to gamble, right, or try to get it in this way. How about sell it in the premium store, make a price of 20 euros for a skin, or 15 euros, or 10 euros, doesn't matter, but person have a choice. Do I want to buy loot boxes, or do I want to buy something else? Same goes for ISU, same goes for Borat. Same goes for Gzor Tank Destroyer, and same goes for Trashante. So people can actually buy it straight. Overall, I think this event is, as usual, fellas, going to be extremely, extremely profitable for everyone. For Wargaming, I'm not even speaking about them, but I'm speaking about us players. I can say my personal opinion. I'm not going to hunt the particular particular box or particular camo here. What I'm going to do, I'm going to buy boxes to prepare for next year ahead of me, right? And if you are a casual player, if you are not playing that much, think how much or do you want to spend at all, right? If you are a player which is playing daily, and I know there is many of you out there, especially in nowadays when majority of us are locked at home, right? So think how much expense you are going to have in gold. And also, fellas, remember, usually after Christmas boxes, after all this thing, right, what is happening, we are having the bled market, right? What that means Wargaming is trying to sink the gold, and we will also have the Type 59 on sale more likely, or maybe even a new tank like Patriot Gold or Defender Gold, or something else, right? So yeah, keep this in mind. And whenever you will get this gold from the game and everything, right, whenever you will have it, don't go left, right, center because you got it that easily, right? Think about the whole years ahead. That's how you can minimize your spendings in the game, right? Once again, that's only me, but that's what I think, fellas. And let me know in the comment section down below my opinion is correct or my opinion is incorrect. Meanwhile, I think it is about the time to play one game with ISU. Sounds like a plan, right? It is the tank which is going to be in the boxes. And one game with a Borat. Once again, the tank is going to be in the boxes, so I will talk about it a bit, and I will try to show you what I think with those vehicles and what is the stronger sides of those tanks, right? So stay tuned for that. Let's move directly to the content, fellas. And we are back. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. ISU is ready for a battle. So let's play a game with this tank. And what this vehicle is. This tank is pretty much created for one particular niche of the players, which loves their ISU. I mean, it's literally identical tank, if I'm not mistaken. This is more accurate and have more penetration, but lower DPM, if I'm not mistaken, right? So if we would check out the gun here. And if we would check the gun here, I think this is the difference which we would see. So, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, DPM is better for the ISU from the Tech 3, but accuracy, and accuracy is better from the Tech 3. So accuracy is worse here. I repeat, accuracy is worse here. But what you are gaining for this, and aiming time is worse. So pretty much this ISU is kind of a bit worse of the Tech 3 ISU, if I remember that correctly. Speaking about penetration is tiny touch better, but it's not humongous, it is not crazy difference in penetration, right? So keep this in mind. My mission, fellas, is to highlight those things to you, and your things is to figure out what do you want to do, right? Without further ado, let's go into the battle with ISU. Skill, you could be a rapper. Thank you. Thank you, fellas. This is exactly what I am aiming for. If, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, if I will ever change my mind about my dream, which I really doubt it's going to be the case because, fellas, I'm lucky bastard. But anyways, I'm going to be a rapper, okay? Here you go. That's the information for you. Yearly information for you, what we are going to do. Okay, what do we have? We have ISU in the Drownenberg, aka old Drownenberg. I used to love this map a lot. Now it's playable. So, what do we have and what do we want to do? I believe our goal, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be, first of all, ISU as a tank. What a flying F this vehicle is. This tank is long range bushwhacker, right? This is exactly what this vehicle is all about. You are sitting in the long range and you are punishing whoever is making one or another mistake. That's the whole idea. Unless you are fighting against the tier 6s, then you can say, Yavol, go in front and bang everyone what is ahead of you. Armor wise, this vehicle do not have any armor whatsoever. So keep this in mind. This tank is made out of one thing, which is gun. Nothing more than that. So that's very important information in my opinion. Meanwhile, Lynx is going like this. Beautiful. By the way, you see how many guys we have in this side? So what that means? That means this side more likely is not going to lose. That's what I think. So what we are going to do, we are going to chill in the spawn. We will enjoy ourselves. We will raise our gun. And we are going to dance with a charioteer. If charioteer is going to do that. Although it's debatable, it's questionable. And charioteer is denying our mating dance. Oh well, what can you do? So, once again, quite simple situation. Currently, we need to wait until enemies will do something silly. Something silly. Or, Lynx. 3, 2, 1, Russia. That wasn't the greatest shot ever, but once again, well deserved, right? Well deserved, my lovely friends. And simply wait, camp in the bush. I don't know. This vehicle, fellas, it is definitely not my style of the tank. But in the same time, it could be definitely worse, right? You could be slow, you could have an accurate gun, but luckily this tank is made in Russia, right? So it shouldn't be as bad. It shouldn't be as bad. I remember when I marked this vehicle, and it wasn't too long ago. We dealt with it, I don't even know, maybe 5 months ago, half years, whenever this tank came into the game, right? I know how ISU is working. ISU can be extremely frustrating as a vehicle itself, and you simply cannot do anything about it, right? It is frustrating, and it doesn't matter what you are going to do. It's just how it works, it's just how it goes. Hi there. Yeah, but in the same time, you know, you can smack someone for a majority of his hit points and you can simply smile for majority of the time. So, once again, ISU gameplay, nothing too crazy, nothing unusual. Everyone knows that, so all good. So, What do we want to do now? We want to wait until enemies will be a bit more brave here, right? As an example, this guy. Hi there, minus 700 in the face. Now we are moving back, but to be fair with you, I don't really care because I don't really think they have any bushwankers in this area. So all we need to do, we need to simply wait until we are going to reload and we are going to repeat the same process once again. Speaking about the process, as you can see, fellas, there is an enemy Ergashem Borshek, which would be very, very dangerous tank. But that's okay. How about the Lynx or Borshek? I would love to hit the Borshek. Aim. Mine. Yeah, ISU gun. Half of the map distance. Schnei directly into the face. Once again, not a big surprise, right, fellas? But once again, it's not for everyone. This vehicle is more likely created for a people which actually have a lot of patience. Why am I saying so? Because if you are not going to have patience, if you will start making pressure for no reason whatsoever, you are going to be in the big massive trouble. And now, fellas, I believe it is about the time to start going in front, right? This is the time when we want to be just tiny touch more aggressive, because our team is swarming them like a bees, right? Or like a wasps. However you are calling this. To be fair with you, this guy is dead, so it's kind of pointless to look towards this way. You know what I think? How about if we would sit here and wait until someone would hit us? Borshek, very, very nice blind shot. That was solid one, fellas. Very, very good blind shot by the Borshek. I knocked the tree down, so he shot me in the face. That's okay. What I'm doing, I am pretty much debating him to shoot the ground here. So all good, exactly what we wanted. And once again, we are just simply waiting. What might happen? This object might try to cross like this, and in fact, this object could already cross, right? If that would be the case, it would be quite complicated thing to deal with, but, you know, we can't change it. It's okay. We are going to be just fine. You see, this Borshek is trying to shoot the trees, which is getting knocked down. And this is a smart move, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. This is a smart move. Cool. Relax, take it easy, we are defending the base. Now, do you have any plans, fellas? Wait, camp in the bush, and have a great day. Very nice. So, boys. What is our initial plan? Is simply to wait until enemies will go a bit more aggressive. If I am going to make a pressure myself, I am a dead meat. You know that and I know that. So that's not a big surprise, is it? Speaking about surprises, hi there. Yep. New tank, you think you have armor? Think again. He had full HP and Not anymore, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. Not anymore. Now the question is, Kill, how good you are at blindshotting things? There is only one way to figure this out. How about one blindshot here? Next blind shot will go there, fellas. What do you think this 274A is capping the base or someone else is doing that? Interesting. Okay, next blind shot should go to this bush here. We'll see. Maybe it will hit someone, maybe it won't. Unfortunately, did not hit anything. Now we are going to load high explosive ammunition because why the heck not, fellas? Why the heck not? All I need to do, I need to get a pixel shot to this guy and we are simply eliminating him from the game. Speaking about my blind shots, Charioteer was in this position and Charioteer was in this bush. Very good information, fellas. Wait. Now. Oi. Fellas. If we hit this Charioteer, we penetrated him for 950 alpha damage, which would be quite great, to be fair with you, but we'll see. We'll see whenever this mother trucker is going to get spotted. I hope, fellas, we hit him. And if we did, I am going to be extremely happy. Once again... a good old ISU. So, what did you expect, fellas? It's Russian tank, red line warrior. You are simply butt someone from behind and you are having a great time. This is literally what this vehicle is all about, fellas. It is bigger than G Fiesta, but since you are playing with a Russian tank, you are going to be fine. So what do we have? We have 1,000 blind and we have 600 blind. We have 3,800 damage already minimum. Actually, more likely 3,900, if I'm not mistaken. So 3,900 damage dealt already. Can we do more? That's the question. And yeah, I'm very, very well aware of that. I have high explosives loaded, which is completely fine. This guy is thinking he is safe. Obviously, reality is a bit different. He is not safe. Then Lynx is trying to save the current situation. Congratulations, Mr. Lynx managed to hit this guy in the face and eliminate him. But he still needs to do a lot of things. As an example, he needs to kill us. And it's not going to be as simple unless enemy ISU is sitting here, right? How we are going to check the things out? I kind of want to go just tiny touch more aggressiver for this Lynx or for this ISU overall, right? That's what we want to do. So let's push in front. Now I will take this bush and I am expecting to penetrate the ISU here. Okay, that's good. Not a big deal whatsoever. I am ignoring this guy because I can. Relax, take it easy. Everything is beautiful. Lynx is trying to shoot my Russian ass. It's not that easy as he might think it is. He's capping base, but he cannot capture the base. So that's something, right? All good. Now we have 30 seconds on the timer. We are going to win the battle whenever time will run out. So what I'm going to do, I am trying to run away and ISU is trying to hunt me. He's saying, "Skill you mother trucker," and I'm saying, "What? What you are saying to me? What you are saying to me, you little bastard?" And he's saying, "Oh my bananas." Beautiful. Nice troll from our side. Lynx is dead and our guy will kill this guy. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful play. Skill, how much damage do you have? 4,100. Skill, are you sure about that? Never ever was so sure, fellas. I could put my PP online and it's going to be 4.1. Actually, now Vivi from the background. Don't put on the bed your PP. Let's see, fellas. What do we have here? 4,100. Skill, it's not 4.1. It's 4.64. Close enough, okay? Close enough, my lovely friends. So, this is the game with ISU. Nothing too crazy. Wanking next to the red line, trying to punish people for their mistakes. Using your Russian game generator, right? That's what you are pretty much doing. Speaking about the profits, we did not make profits in this battle. We truly did not make profits. Let's see. Look. Auto repair vehicle and auto resupply vehicle. Reward for completing the missions. Och tu kurva. I went with a standard ISU. I went into the battle with a standard ISU. Without even equipment. So, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, let's go into the battle with a premium version of the ISU. And today we won't play with a Borat. Today we will play with ISU. You saw the old version, now let's see the new version. I am so bad. I am so... And you know what? We had actually epic battle with that thing. I don't see the difference between ISU Premium and ISU Standard one. So, you see, if we would be playing with a Premium one, we would make shit ton of profits. Since we did not play it with a Premium one, here you go. Not that much profits. Well, as we expected, right? Shame. Shame. Okay, beautiful. What do we want to do now? As you can see, fellas, this is a premium version of the ISU. And this is matchmaking which you actually want. This is a good one. This is a good matchmaking, fellas. Very good matchmaking. So, what is the plan? If And if I'm not mistaken, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, this tank is slower than the standard ISU. Not by miles, but a bit slower. So, what is the goal? What is the plan? What is the dream? I want to take this position here. Skill, why do you want to take this position here? You see, the T-34 eventually will think I am brave enough to cross. And whenever someone will say I am brave enough to cross, and this is the time we are going to say hello there. This is exactly what you are doing with ISU in city maps, right? You are packing the longer line and you are butts punishing someone crossing. This T-32, he got cut by a half, right? So not a big surprise whatsoever, boys. So now the question is, do we want to go into the city super aggressively, or we don't want to go into the city super aggressively? Honestly, I think I kind of could take this angle here and I could eliminate this heavy tank number Russia. 6, it's okay, my ex eliminated him, I tried to join the kill, but hashtag never lucky, which is completely fine. Now we are moving back. Skill, are you sure about moving back? I never ever was so sure. We are going to aim, this guy is very, very brave, and this guy is dead. Yeah, here you go, a Ruski tank in the battlefield. It's not bad vehicle whatsoever. Once again, I said that couple of times before, but it is for very, very specific player base, which likes to sit in the back in majority of the cases and smack people very, very hard. But for that shit, you need to be very, very, very patient. If your main mission is to go in front and try to show the dominance all over the enemies, but honestly, this vehicle is not going to be for you. At least that's my opinion. Anyways, as you can see, Vaka is thinking about crossing here, and that's exactly what we need. And kaboom. Exactly what I wanted to do. I wanted to scare him, okay? This is exactly what I was dreaming about. Why to use the gun when you can use the loud shot sound, right? And he is already shitting his pants. Anyways, now it's about the time to make a pressure, right? Because otherwise it's GG, finito, rip. So what we are doing, we are going for him like this. We are getting ammo react, but we have repair. This guy just shot. What that means, I'm reloading faster than this guy. He's thinking I'm in massive trouble. I agree with him, he's in massive trouble. He's thinking about escaping, he cannot escape. He's thinking about how beautiful life is, and I agree with him, life is very, very beautiful. And he should be dead very, very soon. Skill, what do you mean he should be dead very, very soon? Well, now pay attention what we are going to do. We are trying to craft a bit different angle here, right? Not by much, just tiny touch different angle. And we should be able to find the shot via this pixel here. Relax, take it easy, everything is fine. Pixel, pixel, pixel. Pixel, pixel, shot. I did not manage to punish this cover too. Although I really, really, really wanted to punish him. If I will give my ass for him, it's going to be a massive trouble and it's going to be no bueno. So what I need to wait until Arta maybe will try to smack this guy or something, right? Because so far the things is not looking that great as I would love to. I was trying to turn and Kava 2 understood that. You know what? Let's go like this and how to deal with this mother trucker, huh? How to deal with this mother trucker, fellas? I mean, this ISU cannot do anything for us, and I am pretending I'm not looking for this guy to decide, right? Long, 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 long battle. Once again, wait. Yeah, you know what? I got bored. Enough. Arta, couldn't you do that tiny touch earlier so I could actually have a beautiful battle here, buddy? Okay, unfortunately, fellas, in this kind of situation, things did not went that well as I initially planned or I initially wanted, right? But once again, it is completely fine. If in the last battle on the Drownenberg I would be with this tank instead of premium version, situation would be literally the same thing, right? situation would be literally the same. And once again, that's not a horrible battle. Skill, what do you mean it's not a horrible battle? 2.2 thousand damage, 400 assisting damage, that's not horrible whatsoever. So once again, I'm quite happy. And fellas, yes, this is a premium version. Before that, it was a standard version. Holy bananas. I probably messed up this hard for a very, very first time. And you know what? I'm a human. Okay, I'm a baboon. I don't even know who I am. Fellas, who I am? So feel free to share your shits and giggles in the comment section down below. I hope you had a great time and I hope you enjoyed yourself, right? So yeah, this performance was very, very average, I would say. 2.2 thousand damage, 400 assisting damage, 56,000 profits, nothing too crazy, but that's how this vehicle is working. And my average performance when I played with this tank was 2.7 thousand damage and 400 assisting damage. So that was below average score. Oh well, it happens. So, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you had a blast. I hope you enjoyed yourself. And don't laugh too much from my fail. It happens even for the best, okay? Have a good one, enjoy yourself, and see you next time, fellas. Skill is out. Peace.